always have to relate physical health to get people to better understand physical health and behavioral health. So now, if this happened in the physical health world, a patient with diabetes no longer can see their endocrinologist in the outpatient setting. A person who just had quadruple bypass surgery can no longer see their cardiologist in the outpatient setting to receive follow-up care, to where patients that get discharged from the hospital or have underlying conditions such as major depression disorder, general anxiety disorder, borderline personality disorder, bipolar disorder, they're not able to receive treatment or help for their illness in the outpatient setting. So now what does that do? So now emergency room visits. Emergency rooms are packed every day. Hospitalizations has increased. So now behavioral health has been cut, but now physical health takes the blunt. Now it's going to affect the budget, but just in another area. So now the state budget in behavioral health won't be affected, but now the state budget on the emergency rooms and hospitalizations will be affected. And outcomes will not be what us as providers like to see. As providers, we like to see our outcomes better. We like to know that our patients are getting better. They're receiving the treatment that they deserve. Without outpatient behavioral health services, I believe suicide would be a top three leading causes of death. Depression is the number one leading cause of disability worldwide. I mean, we can't get any higher than that. But I think the amount of people in our community that suffer from depression or behavioral health conditions, along with substance abuse conditions, will be through the roof. I would have to say that now is the time that we stand up and go to our House representatives, our state capitol, and demand that the people in our state deserve better. We're known as the Bible Belt State and the Oklahoma Way, and I assure you that this is not the Oklahoma Way. The people in our community deserve better, and it's imperative that we give them the services that they deserve.